Okay, so we got Jared up there fishing a jig and a bead, and we're gonna set up a bobberdogger on this, but you know, recently we've had a lot of low clear water, so I wasn't actually fishing them on the bottom. I was running a longer leader, and this is about a, 7 foot leader right here, and I'd run a couple split shots on it. One just a little ways down, and then one, about 12 inches above your hook. And today I'm gonna put a soft bead on this, B&R bead. This one's been a good one for me lately. It's real late in the season here, so the egg bite and the bead bite has been good. I'm just gonna slide that up. And today, where we've actually gained a little bit of water, we'll probably bobberdog a little bit, but I'm gonna go ahead and leave these long leaders on because it's still fairly clear too, so we're gonna be a little bit sneakier coming into them. So when I'm fishing them suspended, you know, I'm not bouncing the bottom like you traditionally do bobberdogging. You know, I usually set this somewhere 1 foot to 2 feet, and I'm just making up the difference with my long leader and adding the split shot. So it's fishing suspended, so we're not having that weight down there bouncing around on the fish. When it's clear like that, they're much spookier. So you wanna stay off of them a little bit and just have your rig down there and not a lot of gear bouncing around next to them. Okay, I run lots of different colors of the B&R soft beads. This one though has been really good for me lately. It's the molten red, good late season bead right here. Really represents that egg. It's been a good one for me. You know, in the clear water, I like the oranges, especially, you know, your translucent oranges. In the dirtier water, definitely the shinier, the pinks, things more like that that stand out a little bit more.